Tailwind is putting utility classes in your HTML. You're writing more HTML, less CSS, right? You have your classes and you're doing all your customizing of the look and feel right there by adding or removing certain classes. And here you have basically that concept again with HTMX, and you're writing these additional attributes. So you could probably get away with, in a small application, maybe, you know, pulling in Tailwind, pulling in HTMX, and writing only HTML, like one single page, one file, all HTML, and come up with a somewhat sophisticated web application without writing any CSS or JavaScript.
Yeah, yeah, I agree with that. And I do think that there's a conceptual synergy between Tailwinds and HTMX and HyperScript too, which we'll talk about maybe a little bit later. They're all designed to be in the HTML. They're HTML centric in the sense that you work with HTML, you don't work with some other file. And one concept that I'm trying to push to codify that concept is this idea of locality of behavior. The idea here is that, and I mentioned this earlier, that I thought in jQuery, when you were dealing with jQuery applications, the separation of concerns, everyone knows about separation of concerns, right? Oh, we got to separate our concerns. Well, Tailwind CSS is not separating those concerns. It's kind of saying, no, we're not going to worry. We're going to just put the stuff there in the HTML. And HTMX is similar in that sense, in that there isn't large a focus on separation of concerns, but rather there's an emphasis on what I am calling locality of behavior. And the idea here is that the behavior of a code unit should be as obvious as possible by looking only at that code unit. So if I have a button that does a thing, I don't want to have to look in 10 different places to know why the button looks like it looks or what it does. And that was a problem in jQuery derived. I think this gets at what you were talking about earlier, where it's like, what is going on in this app, right? Where you couldn't figure out what the heck this darn button was doing. And maybe some crazy selector in some JavaScript that lives goodness knows where was what was hooking up the event handler. And so locality of behavior is the terminology that I'm trying to use to describe this idea. You put the behavior of the button on the button, not elsewhere. And that violates separation of concerns. It also, to an extent, conflicts with dry, with don't repeat yourself, because you may embed, you know, in jQuery anyways, you could hook up a behavior to multiple buttons by using some crazy selector, but that was its own problem. And so this is, I think, another design consideration that developers should keep in mind when they're designing their systems. We want locality of behavior. We want to be able to look at a button and understand what the heck it does.